Please don't forget to subscribe, like this video.
Like we said, liking and subscribing motivates us to post more videos. So the more you like, the more you watch, the more you comment, your comments and your opinions, because you know motivation to continue posting and stuff like that.
Knowing that
we value your opinion,
yes.
We value whatever content. Maybe you want us to make more content, you want us to talk to you about something. You go ahead, suggest, give ideas, and we love any of your ideas. Okay guys, so today we are talking about
bad friends
are everywhere, guys. Mm-hmm. everywhere.
And sometimes we as people fail to recognize when we are having bad friends,
or sometimes we recognize our bad friends but we don't have the strength to leave them.
Yes, we don't have the strength to leave them.
But is there anything that someone you think that is a good friend but later on you find out that this person is a bad friend?
Yeah.
Can you remember anything?
I told you guys about it. I remember telling you guys about it. Oh wait, maybe I didn't. So I had a friend when I was in primary school, and every single time we would have an argument, it was I always did something wrong. I was always wrong. I was always the wrong one. I was always the one who did something wrong every single time. It was always me, and I was always the one. Every so we're in a group of friends, so every single time we have an argument with this friend of mine, she would be like, sorry, you have to get out. And I had to get out, and then I would sit behind the school, because you know, if people see me alone, they'll be like, oh my god, why are you sitting alone? Are you like ditch? And then it would go all around the school, and people would be like, oh my god, she doesn't have friends. So I would go behind that side of the school so no one could see me and eat alone my lunch, and then I would wait.
And you was ashamed of, because you was alone.
Yeah, I was alone. I felt ashamed.
I won't even bother if I don't have a friend. I don't bother.
Yeah, now I know. Before, I just didn't know. You know, at the time, I thought, I don't know what I was thinking. Mm. I still don't know what I was thinking.
As a little girl.
And you know, I was just alone. I would sit there behind the and be alone. And then I would wait for her to say, you can come back. And when she said that, I would be so happy, go back to my friends, eat in a group of friends, and I wouldn't feel uncomfortable and stuff like that. And I can't believe I considered that child my best friend.
And you cannot see?
I couldn't see
yes,
anything.
You cannot see.
I was literally blind, so she was always bossing me around. She refused to see when she was wrong. If I did something wrong, then what is it? I have to apologize. But if she does something wrong, she will never apologize. I remember this once. I went to her house, and then she says, oh, you know, she should come to her house. My father just brought honey from where he came from. You should come and taste it. Like, it's real honey. It didn't go through machines. And I was like, really? Yeah, I'm coming over. I come over to her house, and all of a sudden she's like, oh, hey, let's fight. Not fight, like, rock, paper, scissors. No, physically fight. So I'm like, no?
You want to fight?
Yes. She's like, yeah, let's fight physically. And I'm like, really? And I'm a person, at the time I used to love martial arts and stuff like that. And I was like, really? And you're giving me a chance to fight you? Then I was like, yeah, sure. So when we fought, I thought we were gonna, like, you know, play, but she was hitting and it was hurting. So I was like, no, no. So we fought, and then after that, I ended up beating her, and her sister, her siblings were laughing at her. So after that, when we went back to school, she didn't want to talk to me, just
drama happened.
Yeah, drama happened, and she didn't want to talk to me anymore. For I think about a week, she didn't talk to me, and when she doesn't talk to me, she means
really
I have to go
bossing
out.
Around
yeah,
you.
She was bossing me around, and when she didn't talk to me, it means I have to stay out of the group, because that is how it is. If I come to the group, she's just like,
she was the boss of the group.
Yeah, she's basically the boss of the group. If I come to the group and she's angry with me, she's just gonna be like, and then everyone else won't talk. So the only person who used to talk to me was one of my friends, and only after I went to high school, I realized that
you're growing now.
What?
Now you're becoming mature.
You know, I met people that you know.
To see the truth.
Yes.
For
7 years, she was my friend, and I never even realized that. Oh my goodness, what?
What is this? I didn't even realize anything. Only when I got to high school, I met new people and I was starting to have my own character. My own character was forging and I was starting to understand things. And as I started to understand, I realized that she wasn't someone to consider my friend. She wasn't a friend. You know, I don't hate her and I definitely don't have a grudge on her, because, you know, holding a grudge is unhealthy, because the other person might not care about you. They are sleeping and breathing fine while you are just there. Yeah, you know, it's just gonna hurt you alone. So I'm not going to waste my time on someone who doesn't even care about me.
I mean, I don't like people have this, they just have these bad manners. Like, you are talking, this person is starting a story about a gossip about someone. And then you are like, what? No, he was there and he went to what and then he do what and then he did what and then you are there listening. You know what this person do when he will see that person he was gossiping? He's saying, no, Lina was gossiping about you.
Oh, quite frankly, that did actually happen to me. And that girl wanted...
Okay guys, I have a friend, and this friend of mine, we have been in the same class like for 3 years now. In the 8th grade, he was a very awesome person, and also in the 9th grade he was the awesome person. And now when we came to the 10th grade, he suddenly changed. I don't know why, but I think he met not I think he did meet bad friends, and he started smoking. And as he started smoking, he started causing trouble at school, and also he's like a gangster going to rob people at night. And also what I want to say is that, guys, we should really analyze our friends, because the signs show by what they speak. If they start speaking about smoking, then it shows that this one is a bad friend. You shouldn't expect like for them to show it to you.
But some people, they find it, you are cool when you're working with big people. You're
and cool,
it's cool. Hard when you're working with those drug dealers
or guys or whatsoever. You know those girls, you know the guy they hear, oh my God, the guy's in the game. Oh, that's so cute. My God, so what is wrong with you? Do you see that this person is toxic right now? The person is in a game. Why would you? Okay. I have no words left to say. Sometimes it's like, we ladies, sometimes we don't use our head. I mean, you can't date a gangster. That person is not going to bring any motive to you. Just going to put
just
you in danger.
Your time.
Yes.
Wasting your time and putting you in danger.
Mm-hmm.
So the one thing I want to tell is that you need to understand also, what is it that you want in your life? Now you need to have goals that you are set. You cannot be living in life if you don't have goals. If you don't have goals, it means you don't have what you do. You don't have plans with your life.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have a life if you don't know that, okay, by this time I want to acquire this. So how can you acquire this if you have people that are constantly dragging you down?
Mm-hmm.
How can you want people like this? Like for me, I'm not friends with this friend of mine that used to do this to me. I cut off because I know this person is only bringing me low self-esteem, constantly making me feel like I am down, and I do not want a friend like that. You can't be with friends that are telling you to go and rob banks. Those aren't friends. Friends want the best for you. That is what a friend, you know what a good friend is when a friend wants the best for you. When that friend is always there, not a friend who's there when you are, oh wow, you have money. Oh wow, let's go to the mall. No, that's not what you call a friend. A friend is there with you, whether you are in bed or good, and that friend always wants what is best for you. And that friend does not limit you, doesn't drag you down. That friend always wants you to go forward. That is what you call a friend. Know what you want with your life. Think about what you want in your life. And if you know what you want in life, then you'll know who are the right people to associate with. And please, do not be afraid to cut off people that are bringing problem to your life.
Yes.
They are not going. Friends come and go. There are billions. We have 7-point-something population of people here. Friends come and go. They are not going to stay there forever. Imagine if you drink and whatever, party all the time with his friends, but in your 20s they are gone. You don't know who they are anymore. Friends, they come and go. Remember, they are not there to stay. There are too many. You will meet new friends as you get older. Some will stay, some betray, some will hurt you, some will do funny things.
And imagine you're going to jail.
In your way to jail, because
you will
of a
be
friend.
There alone, and then they are enjoying life outside.
Friends
oh
are
God.
Everywhere. You will find friends everywhere. Never be afraid to run away from something that brings you no worth. Mm-hmm. So if this friend of yours is bringing you nothing but trouble, let go. Mm-hmm.
And also, you came alone in this world.
That's where you need to realize that this is a good friend. It's a bad friend.
Yes.
Do not run after fame. And no, if I let go, she's going to bully me. That's not it. It's you. It's about your life. What is it you want inside of your life? A good friend wants what is best for you. Mm. That is what a friend is. Mm-hmm. That is all you need to know about a friend. So guys, remember, it is your choice. You cannot blame your friends. Like, no, it's because I'm so good that I'm like this.
And those, I did those friends that you do good to them and they never say thank you.
They never appreciate you. Let go. Let go, because all these people, you cannot be trying to gain someone. It's just toxic for you. Let it go. Your friends will come and go. Billions of people exist in this world. You're gonna meet someone from Egypt, Europe, America, Africa. You meet new people. So never be afraid to let go.
Our friends.
They come, they go. That is how it is. There are those who stay, there are those who just go and betray you and hurt you. That is all we have to tell you guys. Remember, like I was saying, it's your choice. Do not use your own problems. You say that, no, I didn't finish school because my friends,
my life is like this because of who?
They used to tell me to do drugs. It's your fault. It's your choice.
No.
The friends you choose. Yes. The friends you choose, it's your choice. You choose. So guys,
that's what we have for you. Mm-hmm. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel.
Mm-hmm.
Comment on this video.
Yes, basically tell us, you know, you can drop some comments there, you know, comment, and maybe someone else will see your comment, and you know, maybe if you have experienced a bad friendship, talk about it, maybe someone else will learn from that and go forward. Thank you guys for listening.
Bye.